Hello students, welcome to our new class. In today's class, we are going to learn a programming language which is Python, because in our programming in our object-oriented programming lab, we need this we need to learn this programming language to develop our program object-oriented features. So I am here Supriya Sarkar, a lecturer at Department of CSC. So let's begin the first class with Python. Why we choose Python? Actually, what is Python? We need to know that Python is an interpreted object-oriented high-level programming language with dynamic semantics. So how much dynamic Python is, we will learn gradually. It is created by Guido von Rossum in 1989. He was not very serious about this language first. He at that time the language was not so popular. Basically, in other programming languages we use curly braces, but in case of Python we will see that in Python there are some indentation that that replaces the curly braces. But in comparison to that time, nowadays Python is a very popular language because of its use in AI and machine learning purpose. Python is very simple, easy to learn, its syntax more readable. That is why we select Python rather than Java. It has high level built-in data structures combined with dynamic typing and dynamic binding. Python supports modules and packages. Python has a lot of modules and a huge library. That is why it it makes easy in different situations, which encourages program modularity and code reuse. We need reusability of code because we are our purpose is our lab is based on object-oriented programming. So let's see some features of Python. Python is very simple. So it has simplicity. It has open source properties. Open source means its features is developing day by day. Many programmers working on its features and developing day by day. So and it is free. So we can use Python without any cost. It is also portable. So features are very important features of a good programming language is portability. It has a vast library, so it makes our task easy. It is object oriented, so that we are using in our we are using Python in our object oriented programming lab. Today we will learn some basics of Python, because we are new in Python. So our agenda is Python basics, variables, data types and operators, arrays, flow control and methods. So at first we need to know how to install Python. In today's lecture I am not going to show you how to install it, but I will suggest some videos. In that videos you will see that how to install Python step by step. I will suggest you to go to a Python website and download the most updated version, because I have told you that Python is updating day by day. Python update itself randomly, because many programmers are working on its development. That's why it is very its update is very random. So I want you to download the most updated version. That is why I am not suggesting any version. So install Python in your computer, then install a IDE so that we can write code in the IDE. Otherwise you can use a shell command prompt to write your shell script. So now first, at first, whatever we learn in a programming language, at first we need, we always we started from Hello World. So in case of Python, we will start Hello World first. So now see how to write a program, a normal statement. You see a screenshot here. Here, in case of, I need to tell you something. Python is an interpreter. You already know that what is the interpreter. Interpreter always read a line, only one line. But a compiler always read a complete a group of statements or a complete program. That is the difference of interpreter and a compiler. So in case of compiler, we use compiler in C programming language. And if you know any other language, in that case, we always use compiler to check a program whether it is right correctly written or not. But in case of Python, we can check one line at a time, or we can also Python can check a group of or multiple lines at a time. So Python is an interpreter. So this is also a facility. You can if you write a statement, you can check that statement at once. So here I am showing you a screenshot of my Jupyter notebook. I created a file, and here you are watching at a statement which is print hello world. So you see it is a very simple in comparison with C programming language. In C, you have to at first load the header files, then you have to write the main function. Inside the main function, you have to write the print statement. But here you do not need to write all these things. You just write a print function, not printf. There is a difference with C programming. It is called only print, and inside the print you will just write the statement that you want to show in the output. So there is no semicolon. If I just run this statement, there is a run option. You see there is a run option. You can also run this by pressing shift and enter. It is also goes to a run mode. So if as it is an interpreter, it will run this statement, only this statement, and here is the output, hello world. This is the interface of the Jupyter notebook IDE. You can use an others IDEs too, or you can use shell script also, command prompt also. So the statement is same for all the IDE or all the environment, but it will produce this kind of output. So this is our first program. Now in comparison to C program, Python is so easy. I'm talking about beginners. I'm talking about only for beginners. So Python is very easy for beginners. That is why we choose Python. Next, if I want to comment, make a comment in the code segment, in this block, I want to make a comment. So here you see it is a comment. A comment in Python. In case of C programming, the comment is shown by double slash or slash star slash. But in Python, only accept single line comment. That is why it replaces that double slash by hash sign. When any statement or any line started from hash, that is a comment line. If you want to make multiple line comments, then you have to use a hash sign in every sentence. I hope you understand what I am talking about. So it is a comment, and comment indicates a different color. You see there here. Comment is showing. Comment line is showing in blue color. So it is a comment line, and it has no effect on your program. Now come to various variables and data types. So another thing is this black line, variable declaration and data types. I wrote this line in my Jupyter notebooks. There is a technique. I will show you in the live class how to write this kind of title in your Jupyter notebook file. So this is only our code segment, and this is for a heading or title to make a great look, or to increase the visibility or increase the understandability of your code to others, or also yourself too. So here, in case of C, we have to declare any variable, and also we have to declare its types. But in case of Python, we do not need to declare any variables using it. So here I declare, I'm just explaining this code segment, whatever I write, I wrote here, I just assign 100 to X. That means it is declared. No need to mention whether it is integer or whether it is float. As I just assign 100 to X, that means it is a integer type variable. So it we will see the type of this X later. We will check what is the type of this X variable later. But now we are just learning that how to declare a variable. Here I assign 100 to X, that means it is declared. If I just write X and use shift enter, that means I just want to run the script, it will provide a error message, because when I did not assign any value to a variable, that means it is not declared. So whenever I just assign a value to a variable, that means it is declared. No need to declare its types. It will Python will understand its types by itself. So we the programmer do not need to tell it that what is the type of that variable. So X is here. I just assigned a value, and X is, at that time X it becomes integer type variable. Then I assign float type value to Y. So that means Python will interpret that Y is a float type variable. And then in Z, I assign name. Name is a string type variable. So the data type of Z is string. Now I just want to print those values. So in case of Java, we use plus sign to concatenate, but in case of Python, we use just comma to concatenate something in the print line. So here, in the quotation, you just understand that this is a string. So it will show in the output section. It will be shown in the output section. So X equal to, I want a value. So I want a value here. After this quotation sign, I will just printed the value of X. So here, you see in the output section, X equal to just this portion, this red portion. And the value of X just added here, just concatenated with this state, with this output statement. So here the value of X is 100. That means now X is containing 100. Similarly, Y is containing 10.2, and Z equal to Z is containing name. Name is the string. So let's check it their type. So here, one thing to remember that variables are case sensitive. In Python, variables are case sensitive, like C. In C, you know that capital X is smaller, small x, capital X and lowercase x is not the same. So here it is a lowercase x, and now I wrote a uppercase x. So this x and that x is not the same. Okay, though I just assign another value, another different value. But if you just here, you want to write here a capital X, it will produce a error message, because that capital X and that smaller X is not same. So it is case sensitive. So here I assign another value of for capital X, that is 10.5. I just want to check their types. Type is a built-in function here. So here, whatever showing any green color, whatever is showing to us in green color is the has a specific meaning. So here we just take this black colored X. It has its meaning is defined by us in which purpose we will use this. But in case of this green color syntax, it green color, it means it has a specific meaning. So here type is a built-in function. So type has a argument, a variable here. I provide X here. That means type this type function. This type function will tell us what is the type data type of that variable inside this type function. So here it is showing in the output section. X is the class or the type of X is integer, because in the previous section we wrote X equal to 100. So that means it is an integer. If I use capital X by replacing X, it will provide that it is a float, because we assign 10.5 here. So if I check another example, here I compare X greater than Y. What should be the output of X greater than Y? Obviously, it is a Boolean output. It will provide a Boolean output whether it is a true or false. Whether X greater than Y, X equals to 100 and Y equals to 10.2. That means X equal is greater than Y. That means it is true. It is true. That means it this true value will be holded by this T. So it has a Boolean value. So the type of T equal to Boolean, not the value of T. It means types of T, not the value of T. Value of T will be true, but the type of T will be Boolean. So the resultant of this type function will provide us the data type of this function, of this variable, sorry. So here I write this, I just want to print that value, but if I just write this type X, it will provide the same result, but only the last statement will provide our output, but not the all type X. Only the type T will provide us the result, because it is an interpreter, so it will interpret the every line at a time, but it will, if you write in a block, it will the last statement will provide you the output. But I want to show the all the type. That means I wrote it inside a print function. If you write every line in print function, it will provide every line will print something. Next. Okay, next, now we are dealing with string data types. So if I assign a string type value to my name, here I assign my name Supriya to the variable my name, my underscore name. You cannot write my space name. Remember in C, you have some rules to identify declare any identifier. So the identifier should not contain two words. It should be conjuncted. So here I just use underscore, similar to the C programming. So you cannot write my space name. This is two words, so you have to use one words. So I just added these two words by underscore. You understand that, I know. So my name, my underscore name equal to contain Supriya. So I just want to print the length of this this variable, this is string type variable. So len is a function. So I just pass this variable name, my underscore name, it just outputs 7. because there are seven letters. So length of this variable is seven. And similar to C programming, it starts from zero to six. These all are seven letters. So what I told you that if I write another statement here, this length my name will not print. Only the last statement will show the output, not the previous statements. Previous statements will be executed but not provides output in this same block. So if I if I want to print the every line, then it will provide, every line will provide output. Every line will shown in the output section. I just want to print. It is a string type variable. So if you know that it, every position has an index. So if I want to print any part of this string type variable, then I have to use this index. It's indexing. So here my underscore name has index from 0 to 6. I use here 5. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Why is the fifth index of this string type variable? So it will output a Y. Then list data types. So here, list is similar to array. So I will talk about array later. Come to the list first. So list, you know what is the meaning of a list. So in that case also the same meaning, I declare a list and assign some value. As I assign some value, it is automatically declared in Python. So list equal to, it is similar to array. I use here third bracket, and inside the third bracket, I just wrote some name, C, Java, Python. So here in case of list also, index starts from 0 to 2. If I want to print the two indexed value, it will provide Python because it has two index, 0, 1, 2. Similar to array, I want to show the length of array, length of list by len list here. Here you see, green colored len list, it will provide the length of the list. The length will here, the if I just print this thing, it will provide 3 because the length of this list is 3. Here if I want to slice, I want to make some slice means I don't want to print all the list, but I just want to print some portion of the list. That means I just want to make a slice of it. So I can make a slice like I just want to index like this from where to which portion. So I just want to see the list from suppose 0 to some length. Here I use full length list means it will provide full length. Length list means 3. So it will start from 0. Is its starting index is 0 and the ending index is 3. So I just want to make a slice from 0 to 3. So all the list is shown in the output section. But if I want to use 0 to 1, then only the first element will be shown in the list section. That means I just print some portion of a list, not the full portion. That means I just make a slice of a list. That is how we can make a slice. It is true for a list and also array. We will see it in the later slide. I want to append something. So append is a function. So it not function, actually it is a method. So it can help us to append something. Append means add something. But append add something at the end of the list. So it is the complete list. C, Java, Python is the element, are the elements, and at last we will get a 20. So if I just print the list value, then I just write here list and it will show us the printed output. because I have told you that in the inner block, that means it is a cell, inner cell, cell 45, input cell 45. This means input cell 45 in the cell. If I write something, and the last thing will be printed automatically. I don't want to use print function here, but if I want to print function, if I want to use print function, that is also okay. I wrote print. Sorry, I wrote list, and it will show us the all the outputs. The outputs is C, Java, Python 20, because recently I added Python. Sorry, I added 20 at the end. You see, 20 is added at the end. Next, the use of insert. Insert is also another method. So here, the insert is also help us to insert something in the list, but in a definite position. Here, I just want to insert in the one index. So list starts from zero. So one index means the second position. So now I just printed the list and found that in the second position, 30 is inserted. This is the inserted value and this is the inserted position. So one is a position and 30 is the value and inserted in the second position. Okay, 0, 1. That means 0, 1 means one is the second position and you inserted a value in a specific position, but append help us to insert at the end, not in any other position. There are many other method that help us to do operations with list. So I just skip those things from today's class. Now come to some mathematical operations. So here mathematical operations in Python is very easy comparison to C language or Java language. So here I assign 100 to x and 200 to y. So x contains 100 and y contains 200. So now I just want to print the various operations, the value after do various operations between x and y. I just want to show the values. So if I just add, I can write like this. This is a similar to C function. Sorry, this is similar to C operations. So nothing much. So I just write x plus y, and the output will be seen in the output section. Okay. So 100 plus 20 equal to 300. 200, 100 plus 200 equal to 300. So now I just want to subtract x, subtract y from x, as x is smaller value and y is greater value. So it will produce a negative value. Then similarly, I just multiply these two. It will produce 200, and I divide y divided by x, because y is smaller value. So if I use x divided by y, it will produce error. I divide y by x. So it shows us a fraction value, fraction output 2.0. I just use modulus y modulus x. Here I made a comment, modulus means remainder. So here another operation is x star star 2. X asterisk asterisk 2 means x exponent. It is this double star means it is exponent. So x exponential 2, that means x square. X square is x equals to 100. So 100 square equal to 10,000. Okay, so it means square. So if I use x star star y, that means x exponential y, that means x to the power y. So it will produce another output. So there are so many other operations, but I just skipped those operations from today's basic class. So now come to the array. Similar to C, array is a data structure. In Python, array is a data structure which can hold more than one value at a time. A collection of ordered elements of same type. So array is it should be assured that array contains similar type of data types. This is also same in the C language. Array must contain similar type of data type. So there is a difference between array and list. So I will come to that point later. To perform an operation with array, need to import array module. Array has some module, some kind of module in Python. So if we want to do some operations with array, we need to import that module first. So like header file in C, you have to use some header file for specific purpose. So in case of Python, we have to use some modules for some specific operations. So here, I just imported this module, array module, and I have choice to rename these modules. Sometimes the names are too long. So if I use that lengthy module name in different places, it will create some conflicts or create some trouble. So there is a facility to you can rename that module name. So I rename that module name as AR. So I should not write array every time. So whenever I need to mention that module, I just use ARR or any smaller name if you want to mention it by, call it by that name. So the syntax is, this is the module name as array. Here I can write array, but as I rename it as ARR, so I use ARR. This is the module name, and this is the array name. So array name is so array starts. This is the iteration index that iterate it. So here the values are inserted here 1, 2, 3, 4. There are four values. So here A hold this hold the values. So if I want to print, I did not use print function. This will be similar if I write print A. That is also similar to this statement. I just write A and just press shift enter and to show the output. The output will shown in this way, array I, then these are the values. So if I want to show any indexed value, say I just want to see the value of position 3, that means 0, 1, 2, 3, fourth position. This is the fourth position. The value is what? The 4. 4 is the value, not the position. This is similar. This becomes unintentionally similar to the position and the value, but it means A3 means position number 4, and the position number 4 contains value 4, so the output is 4. If I want to print the length of the array, I can use length A. That means the value, the length is 4, so it is showing 4. So there are some difference between list and array. Array can hold only single data values, single data type values. That means if it contains the integer type value, all the values should be integer, not float or not string. But list has facilities to hold different type of values. So list can hold any data types, any types of values. That means a list contains integer, I can also insert any string value into that list. So now come to some different operations, looping. So I want to print some print a array with loop. You know that array contains a collection of data. That means if I want to print an array, I have to use loop. In the concept of C, you already know that. So if I want to print with for loop, the syntax is very interesting rather than in comparison to C. In C, you have to use curly braces, but in case of Python, you do not have to use any curly braces. It will create error message. So in place of curly braces, you have to use indentation. So indentation means some empty places. You should not use create these empty places. If you want to create these empty places, it will create error message. Be careful about that. When you write the previous sentence correctly and use some colon here and just enter, this empty space will be created automatically. If you try to create these empty places, it will create some error message. I just warn you, remember that. So the syntax is for like like C, and there is no first bracket. There is no first bracket, and this is the iterator. I is the iterator. It will iterate the loop every time. And here, I in A, that means here you use the how many times array will be iterated. The length of A is the last value that I will iterate. The syntax is different. A is the array and I is the iterator. So the interpreter will know that how many times it have to iterate, because it already know the length of A automatically. So it means I will be iterate at the last value of A. And there, this colon sign means, and colon enter means that you have to, you have entered into the for loop. So until you force your cursor to go back to the left side, it will remain here. So it will take some indentation or empty space automatically. That means you are inside the for loop. That means curly braces. But do not use any curly braces. It will create error. Then you write print and you just write the value of the write I. I will contain all the values of A one by one automatically. So do not need to use any semicolon. And you have, if you have any more lines in this for loop, just enter. It will start from this below the print function, below the print function, not from the at the leftmost position. It will go to the under the print function. So it will, it means that you already you still inside the for loop. If you force to move to the left, more left, then it will the interpreter will know that you just break the for loop and write something more outside the for loop. Okay, just try at home. Then this function, this statement will produce the output 1 2 3 4, because the array contains these values 1 2 3 4. So gradually, sequentially, it will produce 1 2 3 4. So you do not need to enter any new line. So I did not enter any new line. So it will automatically produce like this. So what will happen in case of while loop? In case of while loop, you have to initialize like C. You have to initialize the iterator initial value. So the initial value of the iterator is I equal to 0. So here I put a condition inside the while loop. So you do not need to any first bracket here. It will take automatically I less than I. This loop will be continued until I greater than length of A. Length of A means 4. It will take automatically. Length of A is 4. So it the loop will be continued until it becomes equal to 4 or greater than 4. So here we use this two colons. You use a colon sign and just press enter. It will take some indentation like curly braces. Here you want to I just want to show the value of A inside and inside the A, the index is I. This is similar to C language, and at last you have to increase the value of iterator. And if you do not use this value, if you do not iterate this iterate or increment the value of iterator, then it will continue infinite times. It will not break. So because every time I will be zero, that means it will never end. So I have to make a increment statement I equals to I plus 1. You can also use I plus equal to 1, that means similar. So it will also produce the it will also print the value of all the elements of array. Now come to some conditional statement. Condition means if else condition. Here I assign a value of 42 inside A and assign 50 to B. You cannot write in the same line these two variables. You cannot define these two variables in the same line using comma. So here if I use some if statement similar to for loop, you cannot use first bracket here. Just like C, whatever you did in C, there is no bracket. You can just write this statement, write this logic like this without bracket. Here I write condition A greater than B and give a colon and just enter. Then the next line will be started from here. It will also take some indentation because in the case of C, you use curly braces. And Python replaces this curly braces through indentation. So it will take automatically some indentation. So I just write print the value of A. Here the value of A will be printed, not the A will be printed, because this Python interpreter know that there is a value of A. So the value will be printed, not A. So I use comma to add some more things. Here a string will be printed is greater than, and then another comma, and then the value of B. If it is true, A greater than B, is it true? No, it is not true. Actually, the first statement will be false. So the control moves to the next statement, else if. This is not else if, this is elif. In case of Python, the else if replaced by elif. So remember that elif, and there is no bracket, and there is another condition. We know that for if we use condition, for else if we use condition, but only for else we do not use any condition. So elif contain condition A equal B. There is another colon and there is another print statement. If A equal B, then it will print A is equal to B. And the last in the last case, we do not use any condition, because if the control checks all the condition and the it becomes false, and they becomes false, then obviously the last condition will be the true condition. So it will be the true condition. Else if there is no condition and this colon sign, and then there is some indentation, and it will print A is smaller than B, not the A or B. It will be produce some the value of A, and B will produce some value of B. Not produce, it will show in the output section. So 42 is smaller than. That means the last statement is true. So that's all for today's class. We have learned so many basic things in the first class. So there are more things in the basic class, but I have skipped those. You will try at home, and as soon as possible, you should install the Python environment in your computer. So maybe we will talk about more in the live class. So that's all for today's class. Thank you.